I'm a big fan of utilitarian type vehicles, but sometimes I don't mind adding a little bit of sport. This week, it combined both worlds. Hey, welcome to the Station Road Warrior. I'm your host, Grant Robertson. Now, specifically behind me is the 2020 Mercedes GLC 300, most notably known as a sport utility coupe. Now don't get confused this week, it's kind of all about the acronyms. The GLC meets the SUV slash the SUC market, all basically saying sport utility turns into a coupe, and where you see it is on the profile. Now I'm a pretty much straightforward guy when it comes to utilitarian markets, squared off lines, bigger is better. But when I started to kind of address this segment several months ago, I started to get my feet wet of, well, what sport utility coupe can offer. Now, first off, it's the profile. Nice broad stance like we see here, but a sweeping roofline that really dives down here at the back end, obviously implying that coupe-like exterior, really contrasting the bigger is better mentality that I'm used to. From this angle, you can really see the arching effect of this profile, really from the front end right to about the midline, then sweeps down here at the back, culminating to a very modest rear deck lid here on this back hatch, built-in rear spoiler with a little bit of angling up here at the back end. Now, when you talk about a coupe for my size individual, really that means anemic kind of spacing on the inside because it's just going to be small numbers, but not the case when you add the sport utility into this vehicle. That means it's truly got to deliver. Hence the utilitarian side. So that's what I like here on the GLC 300 is it's got good numbers. First off, overall length around about 186 inches. Wheelbase fairly stretched about 113. Other numbers to think about is width around about 74 inches. Add another 8 inches to the width when you include the mirrors. Now as for height, any coupes typically gonna be planted to the ground. But again, this is going to have decent ground clearance around about 5.3 inches. Now, interestingly, I thought it was substantially more than that because it looks like it's jacked up off the ground. Now, with the overall ground clearance, you're going to see about 63 inches in overall height. Now, when it comes to the track, you're going to have a width of about 66 inches in the front, 63 inches in the back. As for the shoes at the four corners, 255, 45s in the front, 285 40s there in the rear, wrapping 20 inch wheels. Sport utility coupes seem to come in one stylized silhouette, but different offerings when it comes to the horsepower in the hood. Now I've tested that as of late with the AMG versions from Mercedes and of course the M series over at BMW. But one thing I've found is when I'm behind the wheel, it feels like I'm harnessing the power of a thoroughbred. And sometimes that just doesn't equate to a nice daily driver. So when I got behind the wheel here of the GLC 300, things seemed a little bit more subdued, both when it comes to power and, well, the design on the outside. Specifically, not a lot of lower flare, not a lot of chiseling or sculpting of the exterior. Really just nice straightforward lines. Really maybe just a hint of a midline right through here. A little bit of raising of lines here on the hood. But otherwise, nice offerings that help subdue the overall feel and look. Now don't get me wrong, the 300 is by no means a slouch when it comes to design elements. I just say it takes a more premium approach versus the AMGs and M series that look a little bit more aggressive. Where you see that is obviously in the chrome accents, even right down to the door handles, which have a dual tone approach with body color and chrome atop. Now down low, instead of flaring out, what you have is a little bit more tucked in and obviously this lower fascia that helps minimize the scrapes and dings. What really sets the tone on this vehicle is certainly the grille warfare. For any sport utility coupe, it's the profile that really sets the tone, but for the GLC 300, I'd argue it's the grille warfare that grabs everyone's attention. Obviously the star power drawing everyone in. Now what I also like is the open face grille with these little diamond accents. Now when it comes to airflow, this is pretty much engulfing everything with this implied open fascia really doing nothing but, well, looking pretty. The only other airflow is really down low. Now as the air sweeps around, you will notice that it does tuck in here and it escapes on the outer side. Now looking at the headlight assembly, a little bit dazzling, split lenses that really allow for a lot of airflow. Now when it comes to safety, first thing you'll notice is the parking sensors. Allows this vehicle to really dive in with ease. Obviously a lot of adaptive cruise control built in here as well, and alertness when it comes to, well, anything that could be a danger or present an accident. Now this vehicle does have cameras, one up front, one on each side, and one at the back for that 360 view. Now let's talk about ingress real quick, and the GLC really delivers the upper level of access. Now first off, it's not just about the doors or the hatch that are locked, but also the Philip Arion. What I like is this works in coordination with the vehicle. Pretty much when the doors are locked, the Philip Arion is as well. When everything's unlocked, this springs open with ease. Now to climb inside, pretty much real intuitive. Go to any access point, put your hand right here, and it unlocks with ease. Now when you go to walk away, just simply press right here barely, and it's obviously going to lock right up. Now, one thing visually I wish it would do is fold the mirrors in, something a lot of the premium vehicles are doing to give you a visual alert that the vehicle is locked. These typically fold in, but not the case here on this 300. So with a sport utility, that means you have the utilitarian side, obviously here at the business end. And well, how does that compare to the likes of other coupes? Well, obviously it's gonna be quite substantial. Even better is a coupe like this, means it's gonna be even better than a sedan, really delivering lots of cargo room. Now, before we get there, let's look at the design. A modest rear arching of the back end, really most notable here at the rear hatch. Down low, pretty much body color all the way around. Dual exhaust and a hint of chrome accents. Now again, it has the backup sensors, backup camera. Really what I found is those are radar-like and obviously coupled nicely with that front infotainment system, so you can visually see what might be in the way. Now back here, several ways to gain access. Obviously here on the key fob, you can push here on the star emblem or just simply go with the motion detector by waving your leg just a couple of times and it rises to the occasion. What I also like is it gets out of the way fairly quickly. And again, with my 6'2" frame, this is easily way out of the headbanging affair. Now, once this is open, what you're gonna see is around about 17.7 cubic feet of space. And most of it obviously is gonna be in the lower region here. As the box or whatever you may wanna put in here creeps up, you'll notice that, well, with the angle, that may be compromised. But one thing I did like is this middle window here gives you a little bit more vertical height because it almost acts as a little cathedral-like area, pretty much meaning it will accept a little bit higher items here through the middle. Now for any coupe, this is obviously a lot of space and really can handle packages with ease. What I truly like is this upper tonneau cover that's built in that covers everything. So at a glance, you just can't see what lies beneath. Now what you also have is lower cargo underneath the floor, nice and deep compartment that can keep things there when you need it. Now, if you do need to expand the cargo into the second row area, real easy to do with a button here on the side, just simply pull on it and it tumbles it forward, one on each side. Now, I mentioned earlier, this isn't the AMG, nor has that kind of rocket science, but it still has a nice turbocharged 2.0 liter inline four-cylinder. Now, it's going to deliver 255 horses and 273 foot-pounds of torque, and also 0-60 numbers just over 6 seconds, which, again, isn't too shabby when, from the outside, it definitely has that fluid architecture and that sport-like appeal, but again, doesn't have all that throttle that makes you just want to harness the beast, but instead, just have a nice leisurely stroll with a little bit of stomp of the gas when you need it. Legroom numbers here on the GLC 300 have yet to be determined, but we found for an evening out with four adults, there was plenty of comfort to go around, partially because of the somewhat elevated rear bench styling. Now, what I guesstimate here at the back end is around about 36, maybe to 38 inches of legroom. In the front, maybe as high as 42 inches. That gave plenty of overall comfort to the front seat drivers and allowed most individuals to slide the seats forward, really accommodating adults with ease in the back seat. When you climb inside the GLC 300, one of the first things you'll notice is the minimal approach when it comes to overall controls and buttons, when it comes to infotainment, climate, and other settings. Really everything right through the middle is housed under this huge touchscreen system. Now this is the home screen here, but you can simply just scroll right across, and if you need to, just simply tap on it, goes full screen. Go right there, goes back to the shortcut. Now if you don't prefer to interact with it at arm stretch, you can just simply use the control system right here, which is really touch sensitive and can go in all different directions, and again has nice shortcuts if you lose your way. Now, what I like about this system here is it's more like a trackpad versus the knobs and control systems we send on other vehicles. This is really nice and intuitive and gives you feedback as you press and navigate through it, really allowing you to understand how you're interacting with the screen up above. Now, once you figure it out, you'll pretty much realize that you can just kind of scroll through, find what you're looking for, and then just simply hit down. Now, once you do that, you can navigate through the screen in different areas. And as you can tell, I'm in the upper portion, but as I go down here, then I can just simply scroll right through the different settings. If I prefer, I can come down to this area. Really a nice trackpad that takes it to the next level versus the control knobs we've seen on other vehicles. Now for comfort in the GLC 300, it was more than just the enveloping seat or the heated and cooled options, but also the mood lighting. And where you'll find that is right here on the screen. Now it gives you lots of options, basically down to the brightness, the color, and you can see how it really illuminates, most notably in the front, but it does wrap around to the back seat area. Now if you want to dive in, look for different colors, you can just simply scroll right through, pick it. It gives you obviously kind of the overall color pattern, as well as some other animation effects. The gauge cluster is a nice digital LCD with an implied analog tach and speedometer with a nice readout in the middle with tons of information. Even better, heads up display there on the windshield that gives you information on the speed as well as the speed limit and the cruise control options. Between the front seats, you'll find this sleek covering here, but what it reveals is nice dual cup holders as well as a wireless charging area. Around the trackpad, you're going to find some other options. First off being the driving mode, what you're going to find is Econo, Comfort, Sport, Sport Plus, and individualized setting. Now, this isn't the AMG model again, but it does allow you to have a little bit more neck snapping fun when you change the driving dynamic. Over here, a nice rolling knob for the volume, as well as the camera select. Now, when you press that, what allows you to do is look at different camera options. Now, you simply just press right there. It's going to give you the viewpoint up front, a little bit more dived in with the aerial shot as well, and here at the back end. That just allows this big screen to harness the power of all the cameras on this vehicle. Now, I mentioned earlier the minimalistic-like approach there in the center of the dash. Where it's not minimal is here on the steering wheel, with tons of buttons that really interact with the different parts of the vehicle. And over here on this side really is for setting cruise. This little button here allows you to kind of go through the setting there on the gauge cluster. On the right side, this relates over here to the screen, allows you to kind of act like a little mouse pad, as well as the home button, so in case you lose your way, and the back button as well, which also have is the controls for entertainment. One thing I don't like is when I can't figure out how to set the seat. Well, even better here on the Mercedes is they do it on the door, so you can give a visual of what you're adjusting right down to the headrest level, the seat back, seat bottom, and the extension on the upper part for your thigh support. And that does it for this additional reward and a test drive behind the wheel of the 2020 Mercedes GLC 300. And after a week-long test drive, what's my final takeaway? Well, I finally met a coupe that this 6'2" frame can easily climb inside. Now, as always, thank you for watching this additional reward. Keep both hands on the wheel and eyes straight ahead.